This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, students. In the previous classes, we started the impact of water jet on moving plates. Already, we completed the impact of horizontal water jet on the moving vertical flat plate. In the discussion, by using Newton's second law of motion, we derive the equation for force Fx exerted by the water jet on the moving vertical flat plate. We also discussed the output energy of the water jet, the input energy of the water jet, the efficiency of the water jet, and also the maximum efficiency of the water jet. These are the concepts we discussed in that impact of horizontal water jet on the moving vertical flat plate. Now, in the today's class, we are going to discuss the another impact of the water jet. The impact of horizontal water jet on the moving inclined flat plate. Here, the flat plate is inclined. It is inclined to the direction of movement of the water jet. It is also moving in the direction of water jet. By using Newton's second law of motion, we are going to discuss the force exerted by the water jet on this moving inclined flat plate. Now, everyone, look at this picture on the cell phone screens in this particular impact. So this is the diagram for this impact. The water jet is horizontal. The flat plate is in the inclined direction, not vertical. The flat plate is in the inclined direction. It is moving in the direction of the water jet. The water jet and the inclined plate, both are moving in the same direction. Both are moving in the same direction. V is the absolute velocity of the water jet. U is the absolute velocity of the flat plate. Here, since that flat plate is in moving condition, the water jet strikes the flat plate with relative velocity. So here, the water jet strikes the flat plate, inclined flat plate, with relative velocity, Vr. We know that the relative velocity Vr is equal to, actually in the vector form, Vr bar is equal to the relative velocity of the water jet with respect to the moving plate. Vr bar is equal to absolute velocity of the water jet, V bar, minus absolute velocity of the moving plate, U bar. But in this impact, the absolute velocity of the water jet, V, absolute velocity of the moving plate, U, both are in the same direction. Since both absolute velocities are in the same direction, the relative velocity of the water jet with respect to the moving inclined flat plate, Vr is equal to V minus U. So the water jet strikes the inclined flat plate with relative velocity Vr is equal to V minus U. This is called the initial relative velocity of the water jet before the impact. That initial relative velocity is acting along the x-axis. Check this inclined flat plate. The inclined flat plate with the direction of the water jet making the angle theta. With the direction of the water jet, the inclined flat plate making the angle theta. So this initial relative velocity, with this inclined flat plate making the angle of theta. Now, after the impact, the water jet flows along the surface of the flat plate. This is the direction of the movement of the water jet after the impact. We assume the surface of this inclined flat plate is a smooth surface, so there is no loss of energy when the water jet strikes the flat plate. So after the impact also, the water jet moves on the surface of the flat plate with the same relative velocity v minus u. Before the impact, the relative velocity is v minus u. After the impact also, the relative velocity is v minus u, because we assume there is no loss of energy of the water jet. There is no loss of energy of the water jet due to this impact. So after the impact also, the relative velocity of the water jet is v minus u. This is called the final relative velocity. It is along the surface of the plate. So here, before the impact, the relative velocity of the water jet is initial relative velocity, VIR. It is acting along the x-axis, horizontal. This is equal to v minus u. After the impact, the final relative velocity of the water jet is v minus u. It is acting along the surface of the plate. Now, let this water jet applies two forces on this inclined flat plate, moving flat plate. One is along the x-axis fx, other one is along the y-axis fy. The water jet applies two forces on the inclined flat plate, moving flat plate, fx along the x-axis, fy along the y-axis. We are going to discuss the equations of the force fx and force fy in this impact. But before going to discuss the equations of the forces fx and fy, first consider the line, that is this n, the line perpendicular to the surface of the inclined flat plate. This dotted line indicated as n, this dotted line is normal. This dotted line is normal, or it is perpendicular to the surface of the inclined flat plate. The water jet applies the another force on the inclined flat plate along this normal direction. The water jet applies the another force on the inclined flat plate along this normal direction. Take that force as Fn. Fn is the force exerted by the water jet on the moving inclined flat plate in the direction perpendicular to the surface of the flat plate. That is Fn. First, prepare the equation for this normal force acting on the inclined flat plate, Fn. Then we can prepare the equations for the forces Fx and Fn, Fy. So by using Newton's second law of motion, we are going to discuss the equation for this normal force Fn acting on the inclined flat plate. So first we are going to discuss the equation for that normal force Fn acting on the inclined flat plate. You know that to prepare that equation of normal force Fn, we apply the Newton's second law of motion. In that Newton's second law of motion, we require the initial relative velocity of the water jet in the direction of force Fn. We also require the final relative velocity of the water jet in the direction of force Fn. So to prepare the equation of force Fn by using Newton's second law of motion, first we must know what is this initial relative velocity of the water jet in the direction of force Fn. What is this final relative velocity of the water jet in the direction of force Fn? Check this initial relative velocity direction. The initial relative velocity VIR is acting along the x-axis. This is the normal to the surface of the inclined plate. With x-axis, this normal with x-axis making the angle of 90 minus theta. With y-axis, this normal line making the angle theta. And with x-axis, this normal line making the angle of 90 minus theta. Because we know that this surface of the plate, please everyone focus this. This surface of the plate with x-axis making the angle theta. The inclined surface of the plate with x-axis making the angle theta. So here also with x-axis, this angle is theta. Whereas this is normal to the inclined plate. This is normal. This dotted line is normal. So with x axis, this normal line making the angle of 90 minus theta. So please everyone understand that angle. The inclined flat plate with x axis making the angle theta. Between the inclined flat plate and this normal, the angle is 90 degrees. So with x axis, this normal line makes an angle of 90 minus theta. So the initial relative velocity of the water jet with this normal line or with this force Fn making the angle of 90 minus theta. Here the angle is 90 minus theta. So the initial relative velocity of the water jet in the direction of force Fn, the initial relative velocity of water jet in the direction of force Fn is Vir cos 90 minus theta. Because this initial relative velocity with this force Fn making the angle of 90 minus theta, the initial relative velocity of the water jet in the direction of force Fn is Vir cos 90 minus theta, that is Vir sin theta. What is Vir? V minus u. So the initial relative velocity of the water jet in the direction of force Fn is V minus u into sin theta. Coming to this final relative velocity, the final relative velocity Vfr is acting along the surface of the inclined plate, whereas this dotted line is normal to that surface of the inclined plate. The force Fn is acting on this normal line. So with this normal force Fn, the final relative velocity Vfr making the angle of 90 degrees, because the final relative velocity is acting along the surface of the plate, whereas this normal force Fn is in the perpendicular to surface of the plate. So the final relative velocity Vfr. So the final relative velocity Vfr, the final relative velocity Vfr with the direction of force Fn makes an angle of 90 minus 90 degrees. Since that final relative velocity with the direction of force Fn making the angle of 90 degrees, the final relative velocity in the direction of force Fn is zero. Because with that force Fn, the final relative velocity making the angle of 90 degrees, the final relative velocity Vfr in that direction of force Fn is zero. Now coming to that derivation of the force Fn by using the Newton second law of motion. So I am going to explain the equation for that normal force Fn by applying the Newton second law of motion. So here in this discussion, since that water jet striking the plate, the water jet striking the plate with relative velocity Vr, the mass of water jet striking the plate per second is equal to rho a into Vr. Because the water jet striking the plate with the relative velocity Vr, the mass of water jet striking the plate per second is rho a into Vr, that is equal to rho a into V minus u. Now coming to the equation for the force Fn. Fn is the normal force. The force exerted by water jet on the inclined flat plate in the direction normal to the surface of the flat plate. So prepare the equation for that force Fn by using the Newton second law of motion. Fn is equal to, according to Newton second law of motion, the normal force Fn is equal to the rate of change of linear momentum, the rate of change of linear momentum of the water jet in the direction of the force Fn. That is Newton second law of motion. Now check that right hand side. Therefore, Fn is equal to, in the numerator, in that numerator, Fn is equal to Fn is equal to, in the numerator, the initial linear momentum. The initial linear momentum of the water jet in the direction of force Fn minus the final linear momentum of water jet in the direction of force Fn divided by time. That is the rate of change of linear momentum of the water jet in the direction of force Fn. So that is the rate of change of linear momentum of the water jet in the direction of force Fn. So the initial linear momentum of water jet in the direction of force Fn minus the final linear momentum of water jet in the direction of force Fn divided by time. Now the first one, the initial linear momentum of water jet in the direction of force Fn is equal to the mass of water jet into the initial relative velocity of water jet in the direction of force Fn. The initial relative velocity of water jet in the direction of force Fn minus the mass of water jet into the final relative velocity of water jet in the direction of force Fn divided by time. Then on the right hand side, take the mass of water jet divided by time as common. Therefore, Fn is equal to the mass of water jet divided by time into the initial relative velocity of the water jet in the direction of force Fn minus the final relative velocity of water jet in the direction of force Fn. Just now we discussed the initial relative velocity of water jet in the direction of force Fn. What is initial relative velocity? Vir. With the direction of force Fn, that initial relative velocity making the angle of 90 degrees minus theta. So the initial relative velocity of the water jet in the direction of force Fn is Vir cos 90 minus theta. So check that right hand side equations. In that right hand side, the equations, the first one, the mass of water jet striking the plate per second. This is the mass of water jet striking the flat plate divided by time. It is also called the mass of water jet striking the flat plate per second. That is equal to rho A into Vr. That is equal to rho A into V minus U. Then the initial relative velocity of water jet in the direction of force Fn is equal to Vir cos 90 minus theta. That is Vir sin theta. But Vir is equal to V minus U. Therefore, the initial relative velocity of water jet in the direction of force Fn, the initial relative velocity of water jet in the direction of force Fn is V minus U sin theta. V minus U sin theta. Now, coming to the final relative velocity of water jets in the direction of force Fn. You know that the final relative velocity of water jet is perpendicular to the direction of the force Fn. Since the final relative velocity Vfr, the final relative velocity is perpendicular to the direction of force Fn, the final relative velocity in the direction of force Fn is zero. So follow that carefully. The final relative velocity Vfr is perpendicular to the direction of force Fn. So the final relative velocity in the direction of force Fn is zero. Substitute them in that equation of Fn. So Fn is equal to the normal force rho A into V minus U into V minus U sin theta minus zero. So from that you will get the normal force equation Fn is equal to rho A into V minus U whole square into sin theta. This is the equation of normal force exerted by the water jet on the inclined moving flat plate. By using Newton's second law of motion, we prepare this equation. The normal force Fn exerted by the water jet on the inclined flat plate, Fn is equal to rho A into V minus U whole square into sin theta. but we require the equations for the force Fx and force Fy. Now check that previous diagram. In that previous diagram, look at that previous diagram. In that previous diagram, the angle between the normal force Fn and force Fx. The force Fx is acting along the x-axis. And this is the normal force Fn. Between the normal force Fn and the force Fx, here this angle is 90 minus theta. And between the normal force and this force Fy along the y-axis, this angle is theta. So this force Fx is equal to Fn cos 90 minus theta. Because here this angle is 90 degrees minus theta, the force Fx is equal to Fn cos 90 minus theta, that is equal to Fn sin theta. So this force Fx is equal to Fn sin theta and force Fy is equal to Fn cos theta. So from this diagram, you can write the equation of force Fx is equal to Fn sin theta, force Fy is equal to Fn cos theta. Just now we prepare the equation for this normal force. Fn is equal to rho A into V minus U whole square into sin theta. Now by using that force Fn equation, prepare the equation for the force Fx and force Fy. So in this impact of horizontal water jet on the inclined flat moving plate, the force Fx exerted by the water jet on the flat plate along x-axis, Fx is equal to Fn sin theta. You know this equation of the normal force Fn. Normal force Fn is equal to rho A V minus U whole square into sin theta. So the equation for this force Fx is rho A V minus U whole square into sin square theta. That is the equation of force Fx. Coming to the equation of force Fy. Force Fy is equal to Fn cos theta. The equation of normal force is rho A V minus U whole square into sin theta into cos theta. Sin theta into cos theta is sin 2 theta by 2. So the equation for this force Fy is rho A V minus U whole square by 2 into sin 2 theta. So in this discussion, the equation 1 is the normal force Fn. By applying the Newton second law of motion, we prepare the equation for this normal force. Then we prepare the equation for the force Fx. The force exerted by water jet on the moving inclined flat plate along the x-axis. Fx is equal to rho A V minus U whole square into sin square theta. Then the force exerted by water jet on the inclined moving flat plate along y-axis. Fy is equal to rho A V minus U whole square by 2 into sin 2 theta. Now in this condition, the flat plate is moving. We know that here the inclined flat plate is in moving condition along the horizontal direction, that is along the x-axis, and the force Fx is acting on that moving plate along x-axis. So here the flat plate is moving horizontally along the x-axis. Check this diagram. So here the inclined flat plate, this inclined flat plate is moving with velocity u along the horizontal direction, that is along x-axis. And the water jet applying the force Fx on this flat plate. Since the water jet applying the force Fx on this moving inclined flat plate, the work is done by the water jet on this moving flat plate. Because the flat plate is in moving condition, the water jet applying the force Fx on the moving plate. Since the water jet applying the force Fx on the moving plate, the work is done by the flat plate on the moving. The work is done by the water jet on the moving flat plate. You know the definition of work. Work is equal to force into distance moved by the body. So we are going to discuss the work done by water jet on the moving inclined flat plate. Coming to the equation for the work done. According to definition of work, the work done by the water jet on the moving inclined flat plate is equal to W, that is equal to force Fx exerted by the water jet on the flat plate into the distance moved by the plate. Work done definition, work is equal to force into distance moved. So the work done by the water jet on the inclined moving flat plate, W is equal to the force Fx exerted by water jets on the inclined moving flat plate into the distance moved by the inclined flat plate. So coming to that calculation of work done, so we are going to discuss the work done by water jets on the inclined moving flat plate. W is equal to the force Fx into distance moved by the plate. Fx is horizontal, plate is moving horizontal. So the work done, W is equal to Fx into distance moved by the inclined flat plate. Now the work done per second, the work done by the water jet on the moving inclined flat plate per second is equal to work done divided by time, because we are calculating the work done per second. Divide the work done with time, work done by time. So here the work done by water jet on the flat plate per second is equal to work done by time. You know this work done, W is equal to Fx into the distance moved by the flat plate divided by time. Please observe this ratio on the right side. The distance moved divided by time is known as, so please everyone look that right hand side, the distance moved divided by time is known as the absolute velocity of the moving plate. Distance moved divided by time is called the absolute velocity of the moving plate. Distance by time, this ratio is called velocity. So the work done by water jet on the moving inclined flat plate per second is equal to Fx into absolute velocity of the moving plate U, because the distance moved by the flat plate divided by time is absolute velocity U. So the work done by water jet on the inclined moving flat plate per second is equal to Fx into U. But you know the equation of force Fx, already we discussed. The equation of force Fx is rho A into V minus U whole square into sine square theta into velocity U. This is the work done by the water jet on the inclined moving flat plate per second. Dear students, we know that the work done by water jet on the moving plate per second is also known as output energy of the water jet. So that equation 4 gives the output energy of the water jet in the inclined moving flat plate. So in the inclined moving flat plate, the output energy of the water jet is equal to the work done by water jets on the moving inclined flat plate per second. That is equal to rho A into V minus U whole square into sine square theta into U. In that equation, rho is the density of water jets. Rho, density of water jet. A is the cross-sectional area of water jet. V is the absolute velocity of the water jet. U is the absolute velocity of the moving plate, moving inclined flat plate. Theta is the angle made by the inclined flat plate with the direction of the water jet. So this equation 4 gives the output energy of the water jet in the inclined moving flat plate. We also know that the water jet is having the input energy. Already in the first condition, I explained that input energy. The water jet coming out from the nozzle with absolute velocity V. Because of that absolute velocity V, at the end of the nozzle, the water jet is having the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is equal to half into mass M into velocity square. So at the end of the nozzle, the kinetic energy of the water jet is equal to half into the mass of water jet coming out from the nozzle into absolute velocity of the water jet square. This is the kinetic energy of the water jet at the end of the nozzle. Now the kinetic energy of the water jet per second is equal to this kinetic energy divided by time. Divide this kinetic energy with time, you will get the kinetic energy that is called initial kinetic energy of the water jet per second. So on the right hand side, divide this equation with time. Divide this entire equation with time, you will get the initial kinetic energy of water jet per second. So here on the right hand side, half into the mass of water jet coming out from the nozzle divided by time. Mass of water jet coming out from the nozzle divided by time into absolute velocity of water jet square. This ratio, the mass of water jet coming out from the nozzle divided by time, is also called as the mass of water jet coming out from the nozzle per second. That ratio is also known as the mass of water jet coming out from the nozzle per second. So the initial kinetic energy of water jet per second, this is also known as the input energy of the water jet. That is equal to half into the mass of water jet coming out from the nozzle per second into the absolute velocity of water jet square. We know that from the nozzle, the mass of water jet coming out from the nozzle per second is rho AV, whereas the mass of water jet striking the moving plate per second is rho A into VR. So please follow this carefully. The mass of water jet coming out from the nozzle per second is rho A into V. Rho is density of water, A is the cross-sectional area of water jet, V is the absolute velocity of water jet. Whereas the mass of water jet striking the moving plate per second is rho A into VR. Because the water jet strikes the moving plate with relative velocity, the mass of water jet striking the moving plate per second is rho A into VR. Whereas here in the initial kinetic energy, the mass of water jet coming out from the nozzle per second is rho AV. Substitute that value in the right hand side, you will get this input energy of water jet. The input energy of water jet, it is equal to the initial kinetic energy of water jet per second, that is equal to half on the right hand side. It is equal to half into rho AV into V square. So the input energy of the water jet is half rho A into V cube. So in this condition too, the impact of horizontal water jets on the moving inclined flat plate. First, we discuss the equation of normal force Fn. We discuss the equation of normal force Fn. Then we discuss the equation of, first we discuss the equation of normal force Fn. Then we discuss the equation for just a minute, please. First, we discuss the equation of normal force Fn. Then we discuss the equation of force Fx, force Fy. Then we discuss the equation of output energy of the water jet. We discuss the equation of output energy of the water jet. That is force Fx into velocity U. Then we discuss the equation for the input energy of water jet, that is half rho A into V cube. Since we know the output energy of water jet and input energy of water jet, we can calculate the efficiency of water jet in the second condition. So please, coming to that calculation of the efficiency of water jet in the second condition, this is the efficiency. In the condition one, I explained, when the plate is in moving condition, the water jet is having the efficiency. The efficiency of water jet in the moving plate condition, nu is equal to output energy of water jet divided by input energy of water jet. That ratio is called the efficiency of the water jet. Dear students, we calculated the output energy of water jet in this condition. Output energy of water jet is rho A V minus U whole square sine square theta into U. we also calculated the equation for the input energy of water jet. The input energy of water jet is half rho A into V cube. So substitute them on the right hand side, cancel this rho A in the numerator and denominator. This two will goes to the numerator. Then in this condition two, what is that condition two? The impact of horizontal water jets on the inclined moving flat plate. In this condition two, the equation for this efficiency of water jet nu is equal to 2u into v minus u whole square into sine square theta divided by v cube. This is the equation for the efficiency of the water jet in the inclined moving flat plate. So this is the second condition in the moving flat plate. So first we discuss the impact of horizontal water jet on the vertical moving flat plate. Then in the condition two, we discussed the impact of horizontal water jet on the inclined moving flat plate. So this is the second condition. Now with this, the inclined, with this inclined moving flat plate, the flat plate conditions are completed. We have two conditions of flat plate. One is the vertical condition, next one is the inclined condition. So with this, the moving flat plate conditions are completed. Next we are going to discuss the another type of moving plate, that is the curved plate. We are going to discuss the impact of water jet on the moving curved plate. So we are going to discuss that moving curved plate conditions. So please coming to that discussion of the moving curved plate. So I am going to discuss the impact of water jet. So check this carefully. The force exerted by water jet on a moving curved plate. So far we discuss the conditions of moving flat plate. In that moving flat plate, we discussed two conditions. First condition, moving vertical flat plate. Second condition, moving inclined flat plate. With that, the flat plates moving conditions completed. Next, we are going to discuss the force exerted by water jet on a moving curved plate. In that moving curved plate, again, we have different conditions. In the moving curved plate, again, we have different conditions. The first condition in the moving curved plate is, check this one, please. The water jet strikes the symmetrical moving curved plate at the center. That is the first condition. So in the first condition, the horizontal water jet striking the moving symmetrical curved plate at the center. Now look at the diagram for this impact of horizontal water jet on the moving symmetrical curved plate at the center. This is the diagram for that. So please everyone focus on this diagram. In the diagram, the water jet is coming out from the nozzle. The water jet is coming out from the nozzle. Here, the water jet is coming out horizontally from the nozzle with absolute velocity V. That is V bar in the vector form. V bar is the absolute velocity of the water jet. Horizontal water jet coming out from the nozzle. That water jet strikes the symmetrical moving curved plate at the center. Look at that curved plate. The curved plate is also moving with velocity u bar. U bar is the absolute velocity of the moving symmetrical curved plate. We consider this curved plate as a symmetrical curved plate. Since it is a symmetrical curved plate, at both ends of the curved plate, at the top end and also at the bottom end, at both ends of the curved plate, the tangent drawn to this curved plate. Check this tangent. This is the tangent drawn to this curved plate at the bottom end. And this is the tangent drawn to the curved plate at the top. Since it is a symmetrical curved plate, the tangents drawn to to the curved plate at both the ends will make the same angle theta with horizontal. At the top end, the tangent is making the angle theta with horizontal. At the bottom end also, the tangent is making the angle theta with horizontal, because the plate is a curved plate, is a symmetrical curved plate. So that is the meaning of the symmetrical curved plate. At both ends of the curved plate, the tangents drawn to the curved plate will make the same angle theta with horizontal if the plate is a symmetrical curved plate. Now look at that impact. The water jet is striking the symmetrical curved plate at the center. The curved plate is also in the moving condition. Since the curved plate is in moving condition, the water jet strikes the curved plate with relative velocity. Because the plate is in moving condition, the water jet strikes the curved plate with relative velocity Vr, that is equal to V minus u. Actually, the relative velocity Vr of the water jet with respect to the moving curved plate Vr bar, that is called as Vr bar. Vr bar is equal to V bar minus u bar. Please everyone check this conditions carefully. Look at this slide on your cell phone screens. Here V bar is the absolute velocity of the water jet. Dear students, in curved plates, we are going to consider the absolute velocities first in the vector form. So please everyone follow that vector form of the absolute velocities. V bar is the absolute velocity of the water jet, horizontal water jet. U bar is the absolute velocity of the symmetrical curved plate. Vr bar is the absolute velocity. Vr bar is the absolute velocity of the water jet with respect to the moving curved plate. This is Vr bar. Vr bar is the relative velocity of the water jet. Vr bar is the relative velocity of water jet with respect to the moving curved plate. According to definition, the relative velocity of the water jet with respect to the moving curved plate, Vr bar is equal to absolute velocity of water jet minus absolute velocity of the curved plate. This is the definition of the relative velocity of the water jet with respect to the curved plate. Since the curved plate is in moving condition, the relative velocity of water jet with respect to the moving curved plate is equal to absolute velocity of water jet minus the absolute velocity of the curved plate. So Vr bar. Vr bar is the relative velocity of the water jet with respect to the curved plate, moving curved plate. Vr bar is equal to V bar minus U bar. But here, the relative velocity Vr bar before impact, the relative velocity Vr bar before impact, absolute velocity V bar, absolute velocity U bar, all are in the same direction. So check this diagram. Here in this impact, the velocity V bar, the velocity U bar, all are acting in the same direction. Since all are acting in the same direction, we consider that Vr is equal to V minus U. Because all are acting in the same direction, we consider that Vr is equal to V minus U. So in this impact, the relative velocity of water jet before impact, the relative velocity of water jet with respect to moving curved plate Vir, initial relative velocity, is V minus U. Because the absolute velocity V bar, absolute velocity U bar, and this relative velocity Vr bar before impact, all are acting in the same direction. Vr before impact is V minus U. That is considered as the initial relative velocity. Then after striking the curved plate, this water jet will move along the surface of the curved plate. After striking the curved plate, the the water jet will moves along the surface of the curved plate at this edge, that is at the end of the curved plate. At the end of the curved plate, the water jet leaves the curved plate in the tangential direction. At the end of the curved plate, the water jet leaves this curved plate in the tangential direction with the same velocity v minus u. We assume the surface of this curved plate is a smooth surface, so there is no loss of energy when the water jet striking the curved plate. So at the end of this curved plate, the water jet leaves the curved plate with the same velocity v minus u in the tangential direction. That is called the final relative velocity vfr. So before impact, the initial relative velocity of the water jet v minus u horizontal. After impact, the final relative velocity of water jet vfr is v minus u, but it is acting in the tangential direction. We know that the tangent at the end of the curved plate with horizontal, making the angle theta. So the final relative velocity of water jet with horizontal, making the angle theta. Then when the water jet strikes the curved plate, let this water jet applies two forces on the symmetrical curved plate. One is Fx along the x-axis, other one is Fy along the y-axis. We are going to discuss the equations for the force Fx and force Fy in this impact by using the Newton's second law of motion. By applying the Newton's second law of motion, we are going to discuss the equations of the force Fx and force Fy. Dear students, in this unit 3 part 1, in unit 3 part 1, please everyone listen this carefully. In the semester examinations, I checked nearly 7 to 8 university question papers, old question papers in hydraulic engineering. What I observed in that old question papers is, in the semester examinations, they are giving the questions in unit 3 on this moving curved plates. Most of the questions in the semester examination are coming from this moving curved plates condition. So in your hydraulic engineering in the second year, second semester, in unit 3, this moving curved plates are very, very important. So we completed the moving flat plate conditions. We have two conditions in the flat plate. One is the moving vertical flat plate condition. Next one is the moving inclined flat plate condition. Those two conditions already we completed. Now we started the moving curved plate conditions. In that moving curved plate condition, the first condition is the impact of horizontal water jet at the center of the moving symmetrical curved plate. That is this diagram on the screen. The impact of horizontal water jet at the center of the moving symmetrical curved plate. So first we consider the water jet. First we consider the horizontal water jet coming out from the nozzle. That water jet is moving horizontally with absolute velocity v bar. The curved plate, symmetrical curved plate, is also in the moving condition. The symmetrical curved plate is moving in the direction of water jet with absolute velocity u bar. Both v bar, u bar are in the same direction. V bar is horizontal, u bar is also horizontal. Both are in the same direction. The water jet striking the curved plate at the center. The curved plate is a symmetrical curved plate. So at both ends of the curved plate, those are called the outlets in this impact. The bottom end is called outlet. The top end is also called outlet, because in this impact, the water jet leaving the curved plate at the ends. Since the water jet leaving the curved plate, we also call this curved plate as curved vane. So from now onwards, I am going to refer the curved plate as a curved vane. So whenever we are in curved vane, it is also indicating the curved plate. So in this condition, the curved vane is a symmetrical curved vane. At both ends of the curved vane, the tangents will make angle theta with horizontal. Since the water jet leaving that curved vane at the ends in this impact, we call those ends of the curved vane as outlets. So in this impact, the water jet striking the curved plate at the center, symmetrical curved plate at the center, with relative velocity, because the curved plate is also in moving condition. So the water jet strikes the symmetrical curved vane at the center with relative velocity vr, that is equal to v minus u. Actually, relative velocity is vr bar, the relative velocity of water jet with respect to the moving curved vane. Vr bar is equal to v bar minus u bar. But here, before impact, the relative velocity of the water jet vr bar, absolute velocity of the water jet v bar, absolute velocity of the curved vane u bar, all are in the same direction, horizontal. So the relative velocity of the water jet magnitude vr is equal to v minus u, that is horizontal. After impact, the water jet moves along the surface of the curved vane. This is that movement. After impact, the water jet moves along the surface of the curved vane. It leaves the curved vane at this edge, that is called outlet. It leaves the curved vane at outlet in the tangential direction. We consider this surface of the curved vane is a smooth surface. So there is no loss of energy when the water jet strikes the curved vane. Since there is no loss of energy at outlet, the water jet leaves the curved vane with the same relative velocity v minus u in the tangential direction. Take that as a final relative velocity vfr. That final relative velocity is in the tangential direction. So with the horizontal, the final relative velocity is making the angle theta. Now, when the water jet striking the moving curved vane at the center, the water jet applies two forces on the curved vane. One force is along x-axis fx, other force is along y-axis fy. Next class, we will discuss the equations for the force fx and force fy. We also discuss the equation of work done because the curved vane is in moving condition, that is called output energy of the water jet. We also discuss the equation of input energy of the water jet. We also discuss the efficiency of the water jet in this symmetrical moving curved plate condition. So with this, I am going to stop the today's class. We will continue this discussion in the tomorrow class. If you have any doubts, you please discuss with me. If you don't have the doubts, you please leave the class.